evening. Tonight, we honor our seniors for their academic achievement. Before we start, I would like to take a few minutes to recognize the people that make this night possible. Many businesses and individuals in our community are responsible for providing the scholarships and opportunities that our students receive even this year when times are tough for so many. Every year, I'm amazed with the generosity and support that our community shows for our seniors. While this year has not ended the way we wanted it, and it's been different than years past. And just when I thought our community couldn't do any more, they proved me wrong. I cannot say thank you enough to everything that you have done to make our seniors feel special and to help them through this tough time. One thing I can say about our community is that you always rise to the top and go above and beyond to help someone in need. So thank you from the bottom of my heart for all that you've done for all of our students over the years, but most of all, what you've done for the class of 2020. So let's get on with the awards night. Tonight, we recognize many students for their hard work and dedication over the last 4 years. This night is one of my favorite nights of the year. We take time to honor and celebrate these young people for all they have achieved and tell them that we could not be any more proud of them. However, it's a little bit of a sad night. Well, there's nobody here to start with. And also, because it's one step closer to that graduation where we say goodbye and wish them the best in their future endeavors. These seniors that we will recognize tonight are some of the best that Jasper County has seen, and it's hard to see them go after 4 very short years. This is a very high achieving group. They are determined to do their best. They have a drive to be better, but most of all, they have had a positive impact on the school as a whole. I could go on and on all night about this class and all the good that they have done and the things that they have taught me, others, and of course our school. But we don't have time for that. So tonight, we'll honor each of these individuals on their achievements and accomplishments. Every year we start off with allowing colleges to come and present, but tonight I will be presenting all of the awards and scholarships on their behalf. And we will start with Olney Central College. Olney Central College is pleased to award the following scholarship to the seniors listed below. Please present the following award on our behalf as we will not be able to attend the award ceremony. For the OCC Foundation Award, Allison Harris, Cade Fitzmaurice, Davalyn Tarr, JC Stevens, Kirsten Good, Lauren Higgs, McCray Goodwin, and Parker Eaton. Olney Central College and the Olney Central College Foundation are pleased to award scholarships and waivers to graduates of the class of 2020 at Newton Community High School with a value of around $11,700. Thank you, OCC. The next college is Lakeland College. Each year, the Lakeland College Foundation awards students more than $400,000 worth of scholarships in a range of amounts based on various criteria. The foundation scholarships are established by individuals or corporations who have an impact by the Lakeland College and may honor a loved one, provide an opportunity for alumni to give back, or allow businesses to invest in the future of our community. I would like to recognize the following students who have received a Lakeland College Foundation scholarship. Alicia Buttery, Hazel Moore Crosby Memorial Cosmetology Scholarship. Ryan Bierster, Don and David Ligon Scholarship. Kelsey Gels, Carol Sanders Endowment. William Oakes, Lutterell Fum Scholarship. The Lakeland College Presidential Scholarship is a full tuition scholarship awarded for up to 2 consecutive academic years. All seniors residing in the Lakeland College District or graduating from an in-district high school who meets the eligibility requirements will be guaranteed the scholarship if they choose to attend Lakeland College this fall semester immediately following high school graduation. To be eligible for the award, the graduate must be within the top 15% of their senior class, have an ACT composite score of 26 or higher, or an SAT score total of 1,230 or higher. I would like to recognize the following students who have expressed interest in the Lakeland College Presidential Scholarship and are eligible to take advantage of this prestigious award. Those recipients are Monica Bierster, Grace Meinhardt, Brianna Utley. The Lakeland College Athletic Scholarship is a full tuition and fee scholarship awarded for up to 2 consecutive academic years. Lakeland College Athletic Coaches award scholarships to talented athletes who, in their judgment, have the outstanding ability to compete on their respective NJCAA team. I would like to recognize the following student who will be receiving a Lakeland College Athletic Scholarship. That recipient is Ms. Kelsey Geltz. The Lakeland College Livestock Judging Scholarship is a full tuition and fee scholarship awarded for up to 2 consecutive academic years. Lakeland College Livestock Judging Coaches award scholarships to talented students who, in their judgment, have the outstanding ability to compete at the collegiate level. I would like to recognize the following student who will receive a Lakeland College Livestock Judging Scholarship, and that individual is Mr. Jarrett Tharp. Congratulations to all you students from Lakeland. The next college is Wabash Valley College. Scholarship recipients from Newton High School are as follows. These students received a faculty career and technical scholarship valued at $1,500 for the 2020-2021 academic year. Those recipients are Trenton Bierster and Gregory Sandshaker. Congratulations. Our final college for the night is Eastern Illinois University. We have 4 individuals that are receiving scholarships. The first one, Connie Hemrich, Distinguished Merit Scholarship, $4,000. The next student, Anissa Massey, Distinguished Merit Scholarship, $4,000. The next one, also a Distinguished Merit Scholarship for $4,000, Emily Ross. And our last recipient for EIU, Olivia Scholl, High Achieving Merit Scholarship, $3,000. Congratulations on behalf of Eastern Illinois University. At this time, we're going to move into our department awards, and how this works is our teachers from each department select the top seniors that they feel really excelled in that department. So the first one that we will go with will be the Agricultural Award. We actually have 2 winners for this. The first one, this is words from Mr. Tarr, says, "Congratulations to all the seniors and thank you for all your hard work and dedication to NCHS. The Agriculture Science Award is given to an individual with great leadership and outstanding work ethic. She is very motivated and is always ready to help the agriculture department. As an FFA leader, she was outstanding. The 2020 Ag Science Award goes to Miss Miranda Oakes. Congratulations, Miranda." We have another one in this department, and this is from Brock Tarr. "This year's Ag Mechanic Award goes to a young man that has done a great job representing the Newton Ag Department in the classroom and shop, but also outside of our building. He has been willing to assist in any way that he can, even if it means he is thrown into attending a section and state ag mechanics contest on a very short notice and does very, very well. Serving as the president and manager of our first class business, he did a great job, obviously, and has the respect of his classmates. I am confident all of these skills will allow him to be successful in the future. Congratulations, Ryan Bierster. We are proud of you. The next department award is from Mrs. Swisher, and she would like to give the following seniors this award: Alyssa Bierman, Cora Bierster, Leah Burke, Alicia Buttery, Lena Fitzmaurice, Bryceland Simmons, JC Stevens, and Hayes Swisher. And Mrs. Swisher wanted me to read the following. I just wanted to tell them thanks for sticking with me all 4 years. I miss them and appreciate all of you. Shade, shade, we love to shade. Mrs. Swisher. The next department is the English department. The English department would like to recognize as the recipients this year as Miss Jacqueline Street and Justin Zumbaugh. Congratulations. Foreign language is the next department award by Mrs. McNeely. She has some words that she wanted me to share. The foreign language department would like to congratulate the recipients of this year's award, Allison Harris and Seth Weber. Allison and Seth have both taken the highest level of Spanish we offer at NCHS. Both of these students have exceeded academically and have shown a real gift for the Spanish language. They have consistently gone above and beyond. It's a true pleasure that we award them with this year's Foreign Language Award. Congratulations, Allison and Seth. The next department award is the Math Department. The recipient of the Math Department Award is Seth Weber, and the math teachers asked me to read the following. Seth is an outstanding young man with a very bright future. His mathematic abilities have always stood out. He has the ability to see and understand math at a different level. He is able to analyze and break down problems in order to solve them. He is also placed first in the pre-calculus division in our region against 7 different schools this year in class 2A. Congratulations, Seth. The next department is the Physical Education Award, and our physical education teachers picked both a male and female to receive this award. The recipients this year are Claire Carr and Keaton Froning. Congratulations to both of you. The science department would like to present both Danae Cantrell and Seth Weber with the science department award. Congratulations, both of you. The final department award for tonight is the social studies department. And Mrs. Flock asked that I read the following. The recipient of the Social Studies Award this year goes to Wyatt Zumbaugh. Wyatt has a passion and love for history and plans to pursue the field after high school. He even demanded that we bring back the History Club to NCHS this year. How could I say no? As president of the History Club, he made an effective effort to research activities for our members. Unfortunately, some of our field trips didn't get to happen, but future years will be able to enjoy his planning and efforts. Wyatt also provided lively discussion and intriguing responses in his social studies classes. I'm proud to announce him as this year's recipient of the Social Studies Department Award. Congratulations and best of luck, Mrs. Block. Congratulations, Wyatt. Now we will move into specific scholarships, and these are just from community, they're from the Academic Foundation, they're just a bunch of different ones. There are some new ones this year. It's always exciting when new ones get started. And then of course there's always the ones we've done for years. So we'll get started with that. The first scholarship for tonight is the PEO scholarship, and the recipients, there are two, and this is for $500, is Abigail Stone and Renee Russell. Congratulations, ladies. The next scholarship is the Christine Oblinger Teacher Education Scholarship. This scholar award will honor a student with a $2,000 award entering his or her freshman year of college. When the recipient enters his or her second semester of their senior year in college, they will receive an additional $2,000 if they are still in the field of education. The 2020 Christine Obling Award recipient is Miss Anissa Massey. Congratulations, Anissa. The Masonic Lodge number 216 scholarship. This is a $500 scholarship, and they picked two individuals for the scholarship this year. And the recipients are Danae Cantrell and Parker Eaton. Congratulations, Danae and Parker. People State Bank offers a People State Bank Business Scholarship. This is a $5,000 scholarship. And the recipient this year of the $5,000 People State Bank is Kyle Schaefer. Congratulations, Kyle. We have a new scholarship this year. It's called the Kent Farley Business Scholarship. This is part of the Academic Foundation. We are pleased to announce that this year's recipient of the Kent Farley Scholarship is Jarrett Tharp. Congratulations, Jarrett. The Newton Rotary Club would like to again present two students with a $500 scholarship. This year's recipients of the Rotary Scholarship are Danae Cantrell and Madeline Hemrich. Another scholarship from the Academic Foundation is the Kyra Sidwell Memorial. This year's recipient will receive $1,500, and the recipient this year is Danae Cantrell. Congratulations. Having a father-in-law and a brother-in-law as members of the Winter Road Masonic Lodge, it is my pleasure to introduce the recipient of the Winter Road Masonic Lodge Scholarship that is $500 to Wyatt Zumbala. Congratulations, Wyatt. The next scholarship is the Miss D Scholarship. A group of former Marching Eagles came together to discuss and reminisce about a woman who had touched all of their lives. The first meeting turned into the Friends of Miss D. The goal of this group is to give back to the woman who gave so much to Jasper County Schools, its students, and the community of Newton. We decided that the best way to honor her would be to do what she did so well, and that was to help students better themselves. So the 2020 Miss D Honorary Scholarships are being presented tonight thanks to the donations of the former students of Miss D. These scholarships are presented to seniors who are pursuing a degree in the field of music, education, or both. Miss D was not only a band director, she was a true educator. The 2020 Miss D $1,000 scholarship goes to Anissa Massey. Congratulations, Anissa. This year, Norse Electric would like to award a $1,000 scholarship to a recipient from Newton Community High School, and that recipient is Ms. Tori Zumbala. Congratulations, Tori. The next scholarship is the Simply Mary Scholarship. They would like to present two $500 scholarships, one going to Monica Bierster and the other one going to Brooke Jansen. Congratulations, Monica and Brooke. The next scholarship is the Farm Bureau Scholarship. The Jasper County Farm Bureau is pleased to announce that they had 6 scholarships that were awarded to students in Jasper County. 5 of them went to our high school students. So for the general scholarships, the first one is Alexis Bell. The next one is Miranda Oaks. And then for the Mattingly Medical Scholarship, the recipients of that one, Tori Zumballen, Drew Kibler, and Brooke Jansen. Congratulations to all of our scholarship recipients. The next scholarship is the Jasper County Home and Community Education Scholarship. They award a $500 scholarship each year, and this year's recipient is Ms. Davalyn Tarr. Congratulations. The Jasper County Soil and Water Conservation would like to award a $500 scholarship to Ms. Miranda Oates. Congratulations, Miranda. The Nick Folk Scholarship is an academic foundation scholarship. The Nick Folk Scholarship is awarded to a senior student who has been involved in track, cross country, band, or the musicals at NCHS during their high school career and displays the meaning of respect, treating others the way they want to be treated, showing kindness and consideration, liking yourself enough to be yourself, and of course, accepting others for who they are. The 2020 recipient will receive a $1,000 scholarship towards his or her college expenses. This year's recipient of the Nick Folk Scholarship is Brianne Duncan. Congratulations. The next 3 scholarships are also academic foundation scholarships, and they are the More Ag, the More Healthcare, and the More Education. The More Agriculture, the More Education, and the More Healthcare Field Scholarships will be awarded to 3 graduating seniors from Newton Community High School. The scholarship recipients will receive $1,000 to help offset educational costs during his or her freshman year. For the More Ag, the recipient this year is Mr. Jarrett Tharp. For the More Education, the recipient is Ms. Kelsey Giltz. And for the More Healthcare Field, Ms. Drew Kibler. Congratulations to all 3 students. The next scholarship is also another academic foundation scholarship. It's the Rhone Ag Scholarship. The Rhone Agriculture Scholarship will be awarded to a graduating senior from Newton Community High School. The scholarship recipient will receive $1,000 to help offset educational costs. This year's recipient of the Rhone Ag Scholarship is Zachary Stark. Congratulations, Zachary. Another academic foundation scholarship is the Betty Hanneman Scholarship, and this is a $1,000 towards college expenses, and the recipient this year is Anissa Massey. Congratulations, Anissa. The Scott Education Scholarship is another academic foundation scholarship. The Scott Academic, the Educational Scholarship was established by Mariana Scott, a retired teacher from Jasper County Unit 1. The scholarship was created to help Jasper County senior who is going into the field of education with college expenses. The 2020 recipient of the $1,000 Scott Educational Scholarship is Allison Harris. Congratulations, Allison. The South Central Scholarship is new this year to us. This scholarship pays for tuition, fees, and books to the community college of the student's choice. This year's recipient of the South Central Scholarship is Zachary Stark. Congratulations, Zachary. The next scholarship is the Lard Dart Memorial Scholarship. The Agriculture Development Association, the ADA, of Crawford County, Illinois, is a nonprofit organization formed to create innovative agriculture enterprises. The Lard Dart Memorial Scholarship was established in 2007 for ADA members, children, and grandchildren who are high school seniors with the plans to pursue agriculture-related degrees. As for this year, 49 students have been named recipients of $1,000 scholarships. Lard Dart, a farmer from Oblong, Illinois, was the founding member of the ADA. He recognized adding value to the crops farmers grew was a key component in productivity and thriving family farms. In tribute to Lard's legacy, the Agriculture Development Association is pleased to award scholarships to two new community high school seniors. Miranda Oaks and William Oaks will both receive a $1,000 Lard Dart Memorial Scholarship. Congratulations to both students. The Jasper County CEO Board would like to recognize an individual and award a $500 scholarship. We're calling it the Jasper County CEO Scholarship, and the recipient of that is Renee Russell. Congratulations, Renee. All right. Along with these are the final Academic Foundation scholarships for the night. We'd like to recognize the following students that have been selected for the 2020 NCHS Academic Foundation Awards. The recipients of a $1,000 scholarship award are Danae Cantrell, Connie Hemrich, Abigail Stone, Seth Weber, and Justin Zubala. The 2020 recipient of the 2,500 Medical Scholar Award is Ms. Jacqueline Street. Congratulations to all of you. I want to take a minute now, that's pretty much all the scholarships that we have for right now. I want to take a minute and recognize some other individuals that sometimes we get the opportunity and sometimes we don't. This year, it was a great honor. We were all very excited to have a student named to the IHSA All-State Academic Team, and let me tell you, this is a big deal. Unfortunately, we weren't able to go to Bloomington and celebrate this individual. They put on a pretty good show for the kids, and they do a good job of celebrating them, but we weren't able to do that. So I wanted to take some time tonight to recognize this young lady and tell you a little bit about IHSA and why it's such a big deal. Each year, schools are invited to nominate two students to the IHSA All-State Academic Team. There are over 490 nominations from IHSA member schools. There were many outstanding nominees for the annual IHSA All-State Academic Team. Being chosen for this award is something both the school and the student can take great pride in. The requirements for the nomination are as follows. A GPA of 3.5 on a 4-point scale. You must have participated in at least two IHSA-sponsored activities during each of the last 2 years, or at least 2 years. The student must have demonstrated outstanding citizenship during his or her high school career. Chosen for the 2019-2020 IHSA All-State Academic Team is Ms. Abigail Stone. We are very proud of Abby for this accomplishment, and we appreciate everything she's done for our school. Congratulations, Abby Stone. The next group of students that I would like to recognize, of course, are our Illinois State Scholars. Another big deal when you're in high school. It's a very prestigious award, very proud of them. The Illinois State Scholars are selected by a combination of class rank and ACT composite scores. Earlier this spring, the following students' academic accomplishments were honored at, we recognized them at a basketball game, and then we also recognized them at the board meeting. We did not get to have our banquet that we have with the ROE. That was canceled, but we did get them recognized a couple of different places. So I'd like to take a moment and announce the names of these students. Danae Cantrell, Emily Dione, Connie Hemrich, Drew Kibler, Kyle Schaefer, Abigail Stone, Jacqueline Street, Seth Weber, and Justin Zumbalen. Congratulations to our Illinois State Scholars. The next part of the award ceremony, this is where we ask students to submit any other awards or scholarships that they received that we didn't recognize tonight. And so I'm just going to read through the ones that submitted to us some other awards and scholarships. They're pretty impressive too. Jackson Bartholomew, Olivet College at Olivet, Michigan. Olivet Presidential Scholarship, $14,000 per year for 4 years, equaling $56,000. Olivet B. Moore Scholarship, $4,000 per year for 4 years, $16,000. Olivet New Michigander Scholarship, $5,000 for 4 years, equaling $20,000, with a total of $92,000. Danae Cantrell, Southern Illinois University, Carbondale, University Excellence Scholarship, $38,000. Aim High Scholarship, $10,000. University Housing Scholarship, $4,000. MAP Grant, $4,950, totaling $56,950 over 4 years. Emily Dione, Southern Illinois University, Edwardsville. Provost Scholarship, $9,123 per year for 4 years, equaling $36,492. Aim High Grant, $2,500 per year for 4 years, equaling $10,000, totaling $46,492. Breanne Duncan, Southern Illinois University, Edwardsville, SIUE, 2020 Scholarship, $2,500. Parker Eaton, Olney Central College, First Presbyterian Church of Newton, $1,250. Claire Griffith, Kaskaskia College, full tuition and books. Connie Hemrich, Eastern Illinois University, Janelle Voigt Jackson English Scholarship, $2,500. Madeline Hemrich, Indiana State University, Academic Distinction Scholarship, $2,500 per year for 4 years, equaling $10,000. Midwest Achievement Scholarship, $2,000 per year for 4 years, equaling $8,000, totaling $18,000 over 4 years. Allison Kuhl, Vincennes University, Volleyball Scholarship, $8,000 per year for 2 years, equaling $16,000. Blue and Gold Scholarship, $2,000 per year for 2 years, equaling $4,000, totaling $20,000. Anissa Massey, Eastern Illinois University, Enola E. Radke Music Scholarship, $1,000 per year for 4 years, $4,000. Miranda Oaks, Pork Producers, $500. Emily Ross, Eastern Illinois University, Talented Student Award Scholarship, $2,000 per year for 4 years, equaling $8,000. Renee Russell, Michael Hindman Education Scholarship, $1,000 during student teaching semester. Abigail Stone, Maryville University, Barat Scholarship, $14,000 per year for 4 years, equaling $56,000. Track and Cross Country Scholarship, $10,000 for a total of $66,000 over 4 years. Jacqueline Street, Southern Illinois University, Carbondale, Chancellor Scholarship, which covers in-state tuition, mandatory fees, room and board, for a total of 4 years, totaling over $102,000. Jenna Zumbalen, Olney Central College, full tuition for concert and community choir. Justin Zumbalen, University of Evansville, UE Academic Scholarship, $28,800 per year for 4 years, equaling $115,200. UE Scholar Award, $1,200 per year for 4 years, equaling $4,800. the LIC scholarship for 500 with a total of $500,000. So at this time, this is normally when we will have the exchange of the gavel. So I would like to turn it over to our student body president this year, Ms. Jacqueline Street.
My name is Jacqueline Street, and I'm the current NCHS student body president. Tonight, I will be handing over the gavel to the person who will be serving NCHS next year. In accordance to our student council constitution, the transfer of the gavel always happens on senior awards night. Thank you for tuning in and taking part of this virtual ceremony for the future student body president. This past year, my leadership role at NCHS has taught me so much. As a perfectionist, one of the hardest lessons that I've learned is that it is okay to mess up and forget things, including accidentally skipping a 35-person meeting that I planned myself. I have learned how to work with different types of personalities, as well as expand my leadership and communication skills. Being in this position has taught me a lot about myself, and I am so thankful for the opportunity. However, I did not do any of this alone, and therefore, I owe several people my gratitude and appreciation. First to Allison Harris, who took on the challenge of being student body president last year, her junior year. Thankfully, she did not graduate with the rest of the senior class and was around this year to give me advice and answer any questions that I had. As many of you know, Allison is not just another person giving me advice. She has been there for me for about 13 years now, and I am so grateful for her. Next to Mrs. Will. If you didn't know, this was her first year as student council advisor. Well, like everything else that she does, Mrs. Will approached the school year calm, collected, and was a true natural. Thank you, Mrs. Will, for the advice and the support that you gave me. I also want to thank Mrs. McNeely. I know no one ever talks about growth in teachers, but over the last 4 years, I've witnessed Mrs. McNeely grow a lot as a student council advisor. I noticed this especially when Mrs. Walker left this past year. Mrs. McNeely can have a lot on her plate, including the entire foreign language department at NCHS, but she always has time for student council. She is always positive and hardworking. Mrs. McNeely, thank you for everything that you've done for me. I'm really going to miss both of the student council advisors. To my officer team, Emma Dione, Emma Kidwell, John Johnson, Allison Harris, McCray Goodwin, and Grace Meinhardt. Thank you guys for stepping up and being ready to help me when I needed it. Each and every one of you did amazing this year. To my student council, I could not be more proud of how this school year turned out. Thank you for letting me lead, you guys. I am excited to see what you accomplish in your future. And finally, to the senior class. Thank you for always participating and having a good attitude about the events that the student council threw. Whether it was supporting sporting events, dressing up for homecoming, or lifting school spirit when powder puff isn't moved inside, I want to thank you guys for setting an amazing example to the student body. The senior class is a really fun group of people. I am so excited to reunite and see you all again, and I want to thank you for the opportunity to let me serve you as student body president. And now, I want to introduce a very special person tonight. This girl has shown me her love for student council numerous times. She truly loves to serve people and her school. There were times as president this year that I had to tell her that she is doing enough on her own and to let others help her out. She reminds me of her aunt, Mrs. Prupps, our amazing principal. Madison, as I leave you this gavel, I know you will excel as a new president. I am challenging you to always show compassion and care for everything that you do at NCHS. I have no doubts that you will be hardworking and dedicated. Teachers, staff, parents, community members, and students, let me be the first one to introduce the 2020-2021 Student Body President, Madison Phillips.
I just want to start off by saying how crazy this situation has been, but if I have learned one thing, it is that when we all come together to support one another, we can do amazing things. I know this isn't how everyone wanted things to go, but I hope you've been able to find a little bit of good in this situation. For me, it is getting to sit down with my family, eat, and share a few laughs. In today's crazy world, we don't slow down enough to enjoy the little things. For anyone that doesn't know who I am Madison Phillips. I will be a senior in the upcoming school year. I'm beyond excited to take on my last year of high school, getting to serve as the 2020-2021 Student Body President. I have been honored to work with Jacqueline when she served as Vice President, and I served as our Student Council Secretary. Jacqueline has been a great role model, and she is leaving behind some pretty big shoes to fill. Sadly, next year she will be going on to college, but I know she is always just a phone call away. With the help of Mrs. Preps, Mrs. Will, Mrs. McNeely, and the rest of my new amazing officer team, we are going to have the best year ever. In the upcoming school year, my goal is to encourage more involvement in dress-up days and other activities from the students. I also want to get to know my fellow officers better and make memories to cherish forever and friendships that last a lifetime. I never thought that I would be in this position. I kept toying around with the idea of running for president, and I kept telling myself I was crazy and I was never going to get it. One of the biggest reasons I didn't want to run for president was I was worried about what my friends were going to think. One night, while I was watching the movie Stargirl, she made a very good point. Stargirl was different from everyone else in the school, but everyone loved her. She always acted herself no matter what people thought of her. One day, she was asked why she dressed the way she did and why she did some of the things she did. Her response was, "Why fit in when you were born to stand out?" Please never forget to be yourself and never change for anyone. Congratulations to the class of 2020. You all have a bright future ahead of you. Thank you. I'm on top of the world, eh? I'm on top.
Thank you, Jacqueline and Madison. Jacqueline, thank you for your leadership this year. You always went above and beyond for your school, and I really appreciate that. I enjoyed working with you. I know that you're going to do great things. To Madison Phillips, congratulations. I look forward to working with you. You have big shoes to fill, but I know that you will. But congratulations, and we'll see what we can accomplish together next year. I would again like to congratulate all of our seniors tonight on their accomplishments and awards. I won't tell you how many times I had to film the conclusion of this. That's a little side note. You'll never know because nobody was here to know how many times I recorded this. But over $700,000 has been awarded to the seniors tonight. That is quite an accomplishment. That's just the awards that we mentioned tonight. That's not, we know there's more out there, but that is just what we know of as tonight. Like I said in the beginning, this group of seniors have been through a time that no other senior has. It's not what we wanted, but these students have certainly made the most of it and stayed very upbeat and positive. They have emailed staff, they've emailed myself, they've made calls, keeping us going when we probably should be doing that for them. So I appreciate them. Some of those are the reasons why those are the main characteristics that I love so much about this group. Which leads me to one last thought that I think is very fitting for this class, and it's one of my favorite quotes of all time. Vivian Green said, "Life isn't about waiting for the storm to pass. It's about learning how to dance in the rain." Thank you, seniors, for showing all of us how to dance in the rain. And like Mrs. Preps always says, keep working hard, chase your dreams, and always, always be you. Congratulations, class of 2020. I'm very, very proud of you. Keep up the good work.